Good morning, everyone, and hope you're having a blessed Wednesday. It's looking like it's going to be a nice day out today. Nice and sunny and warmer, not warm, but warmer. So I may get out and do some filming. Who knows? It's an idea. We'll see what's in the cards. So here we go. Let's see what the card for today will be. It is the Five of Swords. Okay, the Five of Swords means a grave defeat, possibly the final battle. Infamy and dishonor, new enemies arising, possible disaster. If you want to look at it, though, as in a little less harsh ways, five is a quintessence or fifth element in alchemy. In the Five of Swords, the quintessence is experience or what we gain from the aftermath of battle. This is symbolized on the card by the skies opening up, and the darkened battle is in the past. The storm is abating. On the Kabbalistic Tree of Life, the sphere associated with this card is Geburah, or power, which means conflict and judgment. In this Five of Swords, it's revealed the need for power and control, the impetus behind the battle. Geburah is ruled by the planet Mars, known as the Warbringer. The astrological association of Venus and Aquarius gives the meaning of idealism, one of Aquarius's attributes with sensitive romantic Venus. One interpretation is unconventional choices. It may also reveal a clash of fantasy and pragmatism. This is reflected in the card's upright meaning, to retreat when battle is done, rather than continue to fight in a war that cannot be won. The traditional meaning of this card is battle and loss. It often shows family disputes, conflict with managers, or also just being a victim of the system. If you wanted to narrow that down, a lot of times it can be associated with educational and government bodies. In relationship, the card predicts tension and conflict. Overall, the Five of Swords reveals ongoing stress, continual challenges to your position, and often defeat. However, this disruptive Five of Swords manifests for you. The overriding message is that not all is lost. You may not win the battle, but you can recover and walk away with your self-respect, provided you make a gracious exit at the right time. There's a real danger here that you can continue to fight even when the battle is over. Regardless of the provocation, deal with your anger and disappointment. There's a saying, it's all over, bar the shouting. Don't keep shouting too much longer or hope to revisit the situation or relationship. It's done. All right. I know that was a real gloomy one. Let's pull an oracle card with it to see see if we can't get something better out of that. I really hate to leave it on that note. Okay. House. This is equivalent to the King of Hearts. Keywords are home, domesticity, safety, and sanctuary. Rather than using any specific story, we choose to use the archetype of the little cottage in the woods. Nearly every fairy tale heroine or hero either begins their story from their humble home or sought sanctuary in such a place. Snow White found shelter in a little cottage like this. This card can represent safety and security, as well as property, real estate, and physical location. Family gathers here, and secrets might be hiding behind those closed doors. The path of stones leads out as well as in. Basically, it's just referring to what's going on inside that. This card in the house of this card. And if there's war in this card and strife and unhappiness and battling, then this house is not a happy house. A lot to be done to clean this all up. All right. It's just determined not to give me a happy reading there, I swear. I tried. I couldn't get a good one out of it. Anyway, in spite of those cards, I hope you all have a blessed Wednesday. Peace. Believe, because the spirits, they're out there. And until I see you all tomorrow, bye-bye.